Health Study. Multiple risk behaviour interventions in people with severe mental illness. For people with severe mental illness, such as psychosis or bipolar disorder, their lifespan is 15 to 20 years shorter than the average person. A major reason for this is that people with severe mental illness are more likely to develop physical health conditions like diabetes, heart disease, and COPD. However, many of these health conditions are preventable through changes to lifestyle behaviours such as smoking, diet, physical activity, and alcohol use. We comprehensively reviewed studies testing the effectiveness of these interventions and the experience of these interventions in people with SMI. We found interventions to reduce unhealthy behaviours are just as effective in people with SMI as in the general population. In fact, interventions focused only on smoking doubled quit rates. But other benefits had lesser effects. For example, only 2 kilograms in weight loss. Are behaviour change interventions a risk to mental health? Studies show some staff are reluctant to offer people with SMI help to change unhealthy behaviours like smoking, out of concern this may affect mental health. However, our review found no evidence behaviour change interventions worsened mental health symptoms or quality of life. Should we focus on changing one or more unhealthy behaviours? Most people with SMI engage in more than one unhealthy behaviour. A key question is whether to focus on one specific behaviour, such as smoking, or multiple behaviours at the same time. Our initial evidence found focusing on smoking alone may be more effective, whilst trying to change smoking with other behaviours at the same time were ineffective. There was no evidence that targeting diet and physical activity together, compared to separately, increased weight loss. What types of interventions are helpful? Qualitative studies looking at the experiences of people with SMI suggest a range of factors that may help behaviour change. People considered social support from family and friends and peer support key to motivating healthy behaviour change, as well as gaining knowledge of how to change behaviours. People with SMI also reported tailoring interventions to their individual needs was important. Supporting the challenges faced by people with SMI around organisation, structure, and concentration was crucial for effective interventions. Further research. Although people with SMI benefit from behaviour change interventions, there is need for more effective approaches. Further exploration of which behaviours to target for intervention should be carried out, as well as to identify the most effective components of interventions.